Okay, we are going to learn a new topic. We are learning about local self-governments. Okay, in the previous class we have learned about the rural local self-government. Okay, and we are going to learn in this class about the urban local self-government. When we take India, India is a vast country. Okay, it is not ruled by a single person. It is not manageable. Okay, that's why our government is divided into different parts, like the central government, state government, and union means the rural local self government. Okay, and where the powers and functions of the government also divided accordingly. Like it comes under the three lists, like the union list, concurrent list, and the state list. Okay, so because of that, our government is able to rule the country, and all the welfare measures and the steps which is taken to see the benefactory of the people is possible in our country. Okay, now we'll see today the urban local self government. What is the meaning of the word urban? Urban denotes, the word urban denotes the towns and cities. Okay, the word urban denotes towns and cities. Now we'll see the urban local self-governments. Okay, there are different bodies of urban local self-governments are there. Okay, when we see India is, there are four important metropolitan cities are there. Okay, when we talk about the metropolitan cities, what is this metropolitan cities? What are the cities comes under the metropolitan cities? There are four important cities like Mumbai, Chennai, Delhi, and Kolkata. So these are four important metropolitan cities found in India. Okay, now we should know what is metropolitan cities. Metropolitan cities are the big, the important cities in India. Big cities and the important cities in India. Now we'll see what are the important things found in the metropolitan cities. What is the features of this metropolitan cities? When we talk about the metropolitan cities, which city will be called as metropolitan cities? Okay, metropolitan cities should have population above 1 crore. Okay, we found population more than 1 crore. So the population will be more. Okay, what is the population? It is more than 1 crore in the metropolitan cities. And the next thing we can find is, the metropolitan cities will be having the complex problems. The metropolitan cities will be having complex problems. Okay, complex problems means the population is more, so the problems also will be more. And since the problem is more, the complex problems are found more, there will be requirements also more. Okay, now it is the duty of the government to, okay, in order to fulfill the needs of the people and meet the complex problem, to solve the complex problem in the metropolitan cities and also to meet the basic needs of the people, the urban local self government has divided into different parts. Okay, when we see, there are different bodies of urban local self government. What are the different wings of the urban local self government? The first one is municipal corporation. area committee. And the next one is cantonment board. And the next thing is trusteeship council. Council and Port Trust. These are the important wings of the urban local self government. What are the wings? Municipal corporation, municipalities, town area committee, and cantonment board, the trusteeship council, and the port ship. Okay, these are the important bodies of urban local self government. Today we are going to learn about the municipal corporation. Okay, the composition of municipal corporation, the functions of municipal corporation, we are going to learn in this class. Okay, when we take a municipal corporation, first of all we will see the composition of municipal corporation. Okay, what is composition? Okay, who all the people included in this municipal corporation? Okay, the important people who formed in municipal corporation is, first one is the mayor. Okay, mayor. The second one is municipal officer. We can call it as municipal councillor, commissioner, or the chief executive officer. Okay, chief executive officer. And the next person is alderman. Then the different people, the seats are reserved for ST, SC and other backward classes. Okay, and also some of the seats reserved for women. Okay, these are the composition of the municipal corporation. Who all will be there in the municipal corporation? Mayor will be there, deputy mayor will be there, chief executive officer or municipal commissioner will be there, alderman will be there, and some of the seats reserved for ST, SC and OBC group people from the local city or town where the municipal corporation is there, and also some of the seats reserved for women. Okay, now this members of municipal corporation is elected by the adult members of the city. Okay, from the particular town or the city. We follow in India, we follow the universal adult franchise. What is universal adult franchise? It is all the adults who completed the age of 18 has the right to vote. So here also the particular adult members who completed the age of 18 from the particular city, they will elect the municipal members of the municipal corporation. Now we'll see how this mayor is selected. Before that, what's the period of members of municipal corporation? The period of members of municipal corporation is 5 years. Okay, now we'll see how mayor and deputy mayor is selected. Okay, from among the members of municipal corporation, from the elected members of the municipal corporation, the elected members will be select the mayor and the deputy mayor from among themselves. Okay, now the term period of mayor is 1 to 5 years and the deputy mayor. Okay, now what is the duty of the mayor? Mayor, the duty of the mayor is to preside over the meeting. Okay, to if any emergency is there or if any steps need to be taken, it is a duty of the mayor in the metropolitan cities to preside the meeting. Okay, and he will be the chairperson for the meeting and he will discuss the matter along with the other members in the municipal corporation. Did you understand? The next thing is chief executive officer. Okay, or we can call municipal commissioner. He is also elected by the elected members of the municipal corporation. Okay, and when we see the term period of the municipal commissioner is 3 to 5 years. Okay, and the next person who formed in this wing or body of the composition of this municipal corporation is alderman. Who is alderman? Alderman is the elderly respected person from the particular city who take part in the municipal corporation. Okay, alderman is the elderly respected person from the city or town who take part in the municipal corporation is called alderman. Now, seats are reserved for scheduled tribe, scheduled caste and other OBC groups. Okay, and also for women. Now we'll see what are the different functions of municipal corporation. The functions of municipal corporation is classified into two. One is compulsory function, another one is optional function. Okay, compulsory and optional. Okay, some of the functions that comes under compulsory functions, that is public health and sanitation. Okay, public health and sanitation. So in public health and sanitation, what the government must do? Okay, there are different duties are there, and the second duty is water supply, to provide water for the people in the particular place. Then the next one is public work, public service. And the next one is education. See, these are all the important things that comes under the compulsory function of municipal corporation. What are the compulsory function? Public health and sanitation, water supply, public work and education. Now, when we talk about public health and sanitation, it is the duty of the municipal corporation to have to give the constant or periodical checkup with the drainage system and the common washrooms to clean up with the areas, to clean the areas. Okay? So the public health and sanitation, when we talk about, it is the duty of the municipal corporation to give proper medication, medicine supply to the people in the locality where the municipal corporation is there. Okay. Now, to establish, to construct and maintain hospitals, dispensaries, maternity centers, okay, and the first aid centers, or need to be constructed and maintained by the municipal corporation in the cities and towns. And apart from that, the vaccination and inoculation of spread of diseases must be given to the public in the local area under the municipal corporation. These are the important functions comes under the public health and sanitation, and also proper checkup of drainage and cleaning of washrooms. Then the next thing is water supply. It is not only to supply water for the basic needs of the people, there is also important function for the municipal corporation to conserve water. Okay, so it is the duty of the municipal corporation to construct dams, dikes, reservoirs to store water. Okay, and the next thing is public work. what are the things that comes under the public work? Apart from this maintaining health service, the government also need to have the public services which fulfills the needs of the people, which makes the life easier for the people in the locality. Okay, for example, since the population is more in the metropolitan cities, there should be need of flyovers, bridges and proper road network. Okay, so it is the duty of the municipal corporation in the particular area to take control over the construction and maintain activities of bridges and other things like public service, public building like schools, hospitals and other necessary items to be given to the people in the particular municipal corporation. And when we come to education, it is the needs of the people. Okay, it is the basic need. It is the duty of the municipal corporation to give the good education to the particular people, people who live in the particular municipal corporation. So, establishing of the primary, secondary schools, not only the primary, secondary and educational institutions, it is also duty for municipal corporation to establish the adult education in the municipal corporation. Now we will see what are the optional functions of municipal corporation. Okay, when we talk about optional function, there are certain requirements of the people to solve the complex problem in the metropolitan cities. So, what the government must do, it is the duty of the metropolitan cities, it is the duty of the municipal corporation to construct and maintain public health services. Okay. To establish different gardens, park, play centers, fair, okay, malls, okay, to give the entertainment to the people, those who are living in the local area in municipal corporation. Okay, so children, today we have learned about the important wings of the urban local bodies. Different wings are there. The first one is municipal corporation, then municipalities, then a trusteeship council, and also we have learned about containment board, okay, improvement trust, okay, not a trusteeship council, it is improvement trust and port trust, okay. And we have learned about the compulsory and optional functions of the municipal corporation and composition of municipal corporation in this class, okay. Now we are going to discuss little about the municipalities. Okay, in the big towns, the municipalities will be there. Okay, and municipalities will be having different committees. Okay, when we see municipalities, municipalities will be having different committees to take over different duties under it. Okay. So the different committees will take over the duties in, under the municipalities, and it functions properly. And the duty of the municipalities will be undertaken and supervised by the state government. Okay, and the state government grants funds to develop the municipalities in the town areas. When we see the members who all will be there in the municipalities, there will be again mayor will be taking part in municipalities, and again here also we can find the officer, executive officer or commissioner of municipalities will be there, and collector also will be taking part. People from SC ST communities will be there. Women's seats will be reserved for women also. Okay, so children, here we end the class. Okay, today we have learned about the urban local self bodies. and also we have discussed about the municipal corporations, functions of municipal corporations, composition of municipal corporation and municipalities. Okay, little about municipalities. We'll meet in the next class. This is your portion for next test in the next week. So prepare well and study well for your exam. We'll meet again in the next class. Thank you, children.